So I'm setting up a 60th birthday brunch to celebrate my mom's birthday. The doctors told my mom she shouldn't live to see 40, so 60 is huge. So I wanted to kind of get her something special to show that this is an important milestone for her.
Look who it is. Hey, happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
My grandparents are in town from New York right now, and we're gonna celebrate with Sue, her best friend, Miguel, and Miguel's younger brother, Danny.
Happy birthday.
Thank you, sweetie.
Oh, I love you so much. Ooh, I can't believe you're 60. It sounds
Keep
weird.
Keep saying it. One day I'll believe it.
It looks gorgeous.
I'm a balloon freak, too, so.
She loves her balloons.
Is that a hint for the future for Miguel?
No, he hates balloons.
It's like, what's the point, though?
They look really nice.
Well, guys,
all right.
Thank you all so much for coming.
To Lori.
I know this Lori. Makes my mom so happy.
Okay. Happy birthday.
It really
Anna.
Does.
Yeah, we're okay.
Happy birthday. Yeah.
Thank you, everybody.
Now, Mom, I have something for you.
Oh, God, when you say now, Mom, I get nervous. What's this?
Happy birthday.
You didn't have to get me anything. You know that. Being around you
no,
is it.
I got you something very special.
What is this?
It's a kidney.
It's a kidney.
That's something.
So the idea is that this will turn into a beating one day. No.
Oh, honey, I love you so much. I was very, very touched by the kidney necklace. My kidney disease got so advanced that the doctors felt it was definitely time for me to go on the transplant list. Sarah wanted to go and be tested. And she came back as a match. How many young kids are willing to say, here, Mom, take my kidney. I want to give you mine.
It's my promise to you that we will get you a real kidney when you need it.
Thank you.
I got my mom a kidney necklace, and it's supposed to have the same meaning as a promise ring. One day when she needs a kidney, I promise I will give her one.
Cheers. To your future mother-in-law's brunch? I don't know about... Slow your roll. No pressure. That was a crazy gift that she got her, a kidney necklace.
Yeah, she's offered to give her mom her kidney if things ever get, like, really, really bad and she needs one.
Like, what kind of, like, procedure is that? Like, I'm sure that's super serious for Sarah, no?
It's super serious. I'm just hoping it doesn't have to get that far, because I really haven't told her my true feelings. Like, I feel like I've insinuated it, but never told her.
If you told her how you
actually... She would find it insensitive if I told her exactly how I truly feel about the situation. Because let's be real, I don't want her to just give up her kidney willingly.
I mean, personally, if it were me, I would definitely have a conversation about it, because it's going to change your life as well.
We'll see. It definitely has to come out at some point, so we'll leave it at that. If I didn't voice my concerns to Sarah about giving up her kidney, I would definitely regret it. Sarah and I are definitely gonna have to have a conversation, and it's gonna be a tough one. What's going on?
I had fun at my mom's birthday.
Definitely, you know, good food.
It was great.
Who could say no to that? Now that it's over, we can relax a little bit, right?
I mean, I guess, with the party planning at least. What did you think of the kidney necklace I got my mom?
She seemed like she really liked it, so that was a great thing.
I mean, it had so much meaning behind it, because it's like, essentially it's a promise. I just want her to know that she doesn't have to live in fear of dying because she won't have a live kidney donor if she needs it when the time comes.
I get it, you know, but when I was at Sarah's mother's birthday party, you know, my little brother was the one to tell me that I should, you know, be upfront, honest with Sarah about how I truly feel about the situation with the kidney. I do have concerns, though. How is it gonna affect you living, you know, the rest of your life? You know, God forbid what happens if your the only kidney you have left, you know, you have a problem with it, also, you know, how does it affect you for our future, like with kids and all? What if you have complications, things like that? These are, I have no knowledge about this. So that's, you know, those are my concerns about, like, you know, when it comes to you potentially giving up a kidney for your mother.
I totally understand why you're concerned, but I'm a perfect match, and it's so rare to find a perfect match that I just feel like it was something I meant to do, especially, you know, she has suffered her entire life to help me. How could I just watch her suffer when I'm healthy and able to help her? I've told Miguel from the very beginning that I would give my mom my kidney if she needed it. However, 3.5 years ago, when you tell someone that, you don't necessarily have a lifetime relationship planned. So I feel like when you tell someone you're giving up an organ, it's something they hear, but they don't necessarily fully digest until it gets a little bit more serious.
Every day I'm learning something new about this whole process, you know, going through with your mom. You know, I guess one of my main concerns is, like, you having kids. You know, I definitely hope it doesn't affect you or, you know, in any way potentially harm you if you were to, you know, get pregnant in the future. I definitely do want, you know, a kid, at least one.
So I don't know how to say this, like, without just saying it, but, like, kids really aren't my dream. I don't see that as something I'll ever want, honestly. I guess I've always been taking care of someone, so the idea of taking care of someone else, just, like, I guess it doesn't excite me as much. It's never really been my dream to be a mom.
So I want kids, definitely, you know, and it's just something I want you to consider.
If I don't change my mind about kids, would you change your mind about wanting to get married?
You know, I'd be disappointed. There's just no way around it. I would be disappointed. So, you know, right now all I can do is just do everything possible to make you want to have one in the future.
Is this a deal breaker?
I left my heart in a box next to some letters I wrote for you.
In the end, I do have my concerns.
Maybe I think we're in trouble.
I'm worried about my mom. I'm worried about her health and as it's declining. I'm worried about giving her a kidney. It's not like that's an easy thing for me in the first place. And then now Miguel's throwing this kids thing at me when it's like, whoa, you haven't even given me what I wanted. Like, we haven't gotten married, we're not engaged. And it's like, now you're just hitting me with kids. I just feel like I can never catch a break. If it came down to it and I had to choose between my mom's health and giving her a kidney or being in a relationship with Miguel, I'd have to pick my mom. Like, I can't not give her a kidney. I can't not save her life, you know? Like, and Miguel just has to understand that. Like, I can't leave my mom to die if I can help her.